sunshine and fulfilled dreams. My wife and I shall be making a journey there this year, and we have discovered a path to get there even faster. It may be dangerous, but if we survive, we'll make history. Now who's with me?
And so the idea for the fateful journey was introduced by James Reed, a businessman, who wished to take his ailing wife to a warmer climate in California. Along the trail, the initial few met with the Donners among other families and formed the doomed Donner Party. The Donner Party made sure to bring sufficient supplies for their journey, much of which they bought in Springfield, Illinois before leaving.
The party began their journey by following a path laid out for them by trail guide Lanford Hastings. He left notes and markings along the trail so as the group traveled, they would know where they were going.
It was here that the first death of the journey occurred. Sarah Keys, an elderly woman and the mother-in-law of the Reeds, died and was buried near the Big Blue River.
Oh no, are you okay?
She doesn't have a pulse.
Oh no,
she's dead.
Oh, they're coming.
Let's bury her over there.
Oh.
In July of 1846, the Donner Party arrived at Fort Laramie, a trading post, and met James Kliman, a traveler who would advise them about their journey.
Jonathan, I just got back from California.
Really? We're going there ourselves.
Oh, really? I took the shortcut.
Really? We were thinking about a shortcut. We were about to do that.
No, I don't think you guys should do that.
Why? Why not?
That's a good move. Y'all are stupid.
Rude? How? I'm just offended. You offended my wife? What?
I'm hurt. I'm so
hurt. I am truly. You affected me.
You know why?
I cannot.
You threw water on me. Right,
I can't.
I can't either. Okay.
Clearly, we're taking the short.
In mid-August in Utah, the group received another note from Hastings.
From Hastings, I think. It says we should wait here and that he'll come and he'll lead us across.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Okay.
Wait here.
We should make a fire.
Mrs. Reed!
I'm done with your attitude. I don't have wood.
Burn the frickin' note.
Burn your hat.
I like this hat. We should burn
it. Like 3 days. We should, let's just go. I think we can do it.
He should have been here by now.
Yeah, he's probably dead or something. I think we can figure it out.
He knew when we left.
Let's go.
It was here that the group went dreadfully wrong. After waiting for Hastings for 3 days, the group decided to venture off on their own through the Great Salt Lake Desert shortcut. Instead of cutting off time, this actually added time onto their journey and caused them to get stuck in the Sierra Nevada.
As winter approached, a disaster occurred. George Donner severely hurt his arm while fixing a wagon axle and was forced to stay behind with 22 others as the rest of the group traveled to what would become known as Donner Lake. The shortcut the group had taken had caused them to miss the available crossing of the mountains. They remained stuck at two different locations and resorted to cannibalism to thwart starvation.
We haven't eaten anything in days. We ate the oxen, we ate the horse, we ate our shoes a long time ago. I think the only thing left to actually eat is my hat.
Or those potato bugs.
Yeah, or the potato bugs, but that's not really a potato. You're looking kind of pale, are you alright? Listen, we haven't eaten in a long time. I wasn't kidding, I'm starving and I don't see any other options. Handy that. Which parts are you supposed to eat?
Probably the hands and feet.
The hands and feet? Guess it's dinner time then.
After months of severe starvation and dehydration, George Donner succumbed to gangrene. His wife refused to leave his side.
You have to. Come on.
Today's been such a rough day. We lost John today.
John was his name?
Yeah, John.
Jacob last week.
Oh my gosh.
And Mr. Jingle.
Oh, Mr. Jingle.
And then what was the last one? Bob.
Yeah, Bob. We should do something about this. We need a rescue team.
Yeah, we have no clue where we're going. We need like
someone
to guide us.
Yeah. Where would a guide be? I don't know where a guide would be.
How about this one?
And so a group of 10 people, including James and Mrs. Reed, broke off from the rest of their already split group to form a search party known as the Forlorn Hope Group. They traveled to California with two Native Americans, Salvador and Luis, as their guides.
Hey, you should go check out that fork in the road up there.
Yeah, we need to see what's going on.
I'm starving.
It's on the devil. You can see it.
It's a straight path.
Yeah,
like,
it's literally there.
So,
hey, Salvador,
come back.
Here.
Hey,
there's a message
for you.
Dinner time!
And so the Forlorn Hope group killed their two Indian guides, Luis and Salvador, who became the only two people of the entire journey who would be murdered for food. The guides were killed after they refused to engage in earlier cannibalism with the group.
After months of grueling travel over snow and rocky terrain, the five surviving members of the 10-person Forlorn Hope group reached California and begged for a rescue party.
I'm off to rescue a family!
The rescue party journeyed to both Alder Creek and Donner Lake and managed to rescue several travelers, but many had already passed, including George and Elizabeth Donner.
I think they're dead. Oh, they're dead, man. Darn it.
The Donner Party's supposed shortcut across the Great Salt Lake Desert proved to be a fatal mistake, resulting in the party becoming trapped and resorting to eating oxen, dogs, and eventually the corpses of each other. Had the party chosen to not take the shortcut, they would have made it across the Sierra Nevada in time. They missed their crossing by 2 days. In the end, this mistake led to death, devastation, and the shattering of humanity's great taboo, cannibalism.
Just say it.
You look like a worm.